Welcome to Prophetic Rewind. This is something very dear to my heart, and I have gone back through our archives and found some amazing moments with my dad. Teachings, him traveling and preaching, him on the den, him prophesying, amazing worship moments. And I just knew that I had to share it with you. So I just want to welcome you once again for this week's Prophetic Rewind. Let's go.
Come on, come on, raise your hands. changing. For the presence of the Lord is about to bring a sail to you. In that family, your family.
Why would God extend your years? What he just gave you was a multiplication of vision. You must live to see the first marriage. That doesn't mean we have to accelerate the marriage. He wants to extend your vision. So your bones, your blood, your brain can be kept strong for this day and age. You have prayed for this prophet. This prophet prays for you and your house. Bob Hope set the standard for death in this day and age, says the Lord. How old was he? 100? No, Bob Hope. 100? Okay. Could you live to 100?
Yeah.
Would you? Yes, then shout it out.
Tear down instead of tending.
Am I getting too pastoral? You can't get away from the gathering of the saints. You can't get away from the church gathering. You can't get away from it. The church, I'm not even talking about this religious organization. I'm talking about the church that Christ is building, not that we're building. Part of that is eternal. That's what he wants. You got to partner with in action, risks, and profit. You gain to profit from it then. And then finally, and this is it, he tells you, flee. He's going to flee. You're going to serve. You're going to tend sheep. But here it is. 13, verse 13. By a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. And by a prophet, Israel was preserved. I'm trying to show you that there is a preserving power. When the word of the Lord comes to a people, a prophet immediately brings you out of the captivity that's holding you from getting into your land of promise. Okay? I'll shout in a minute. By a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. Prophet brings deliverance from your captivity, your struggles, whatever you want to call them. It's all here. But now I looked up the word preserve, and I want everyone in this house to get ready to receive this. And by the prophet, Israel was preserved. That's you. I love the word preserve in the Bible and how it explains it. The word preserve means a place set apart for your protection. A place set apart for your preparation. A place set apart for propagation. Listen now. Which means multiplication by reproduction and transmission. Which means to transmit. When you come into the prophet, you're going to start transmitting. Hello? There's a protection. There's a preparation. The word preserve means to keep you in existence. 89, when does he turn 90? A year from now? Come on, I've got my eye on you. Because God wants you to know that the cure that people have been praying for Alzheimer's and neurodiseases, one thing, overnight, and it's all changed. And it's happening now. You must live to see it. That was inside of David, and even that kept him, and that preserved him by the correction of the voice of the prophet. Do you know that Jehoshaphat was preserved by a prophet when he stood before the nations strength because of your prayer. Because there's a deep prayer in your heart. For Rena, God said, I've heard that prayer. And as I said, a little editing and correcting, resubmission, and it's going to all be fine. Don't fear. Your son is about to meet a messenger in his journey to the place that he thinks is where God wants him. But your prayers are more powerful than you realize, cutting and shaping the future of your children. So God said, lift your voice and thank me, Charlene, because what you're going to see, Mrs. Sharp, in the future is more exciting than what you've seen in the past. Come on, give him a shout of praise. That young lady, clap your hands in. Thank you for your prayers. God has put things in your heart. You don't even understand some of the stuff that's happening. But what you do understand is, it's bringing life to me. As a younger person, you will get through the battles that try to enslave you and form you and shape you to be someone you didn't want to be. But God said, you're going to be the person you dreamed to be and build the thing that you know is something that is special for human beings. You have a special heart, a tenderness, and you pray for a prophet, and God said, you get a prophet's reward, and I'm going to reward you with something that you never dreamed about, and it's going to become part and parcel of your future. So therefore, take this love that God has given you and receive it for everything that took place in the past, an abuse against you, against your mind. God said, you are free from that because you are going to take your children and raise them up to be giants in the kingdom, says the Spirit of the living God. Come on! Everybody stand with me. Let's give them a shout of praise. Let's raise our hands and pray this way together. Father, right now, I receive every prophetic promise for myself, my family, my ministry, my expression.
Thank you so much for watching. And thank you for going back in time with me and having these incredible moments with my dad. You know, one thing about my dad is that he was one of a kind. And I'll tell you something, he is irreplaceable. And he was a precious and beautiful gift. And the passion of my heart is to put out there as much as I can of what he did. Because my father labored for 40 years. He traveled all over the world, to countries all over the world, all over the United States. And I have found in our archives some incredible, incredible moments that you have never seen. And so that's why I'm doing this. I'm sharing this because there are prophetic moments and words that, even though he said it years ago, are relevant right now for the time that we're living in. I'm so passionate about getting that out there, getting that to you to see these moments, to hear these insights. And in order to do that, I need your support too. And so if you're enjoying these prophetic rewinds, if you like traveling through time with me and seeing my father in the past, if this is blessing you and blessing your life, and especially, we put these out on a Monday because I know that this is the beginning of your week and I want you to be inspired as you go into your week and that you have a prophetic mindset, a prophetic insight, something to drive you as you go through your week because life is hard. Your support is an offering to God. It's an offering to God, and it also supports me in what I'm doing and trying to get as much of my dad out there and what he did and share it with the world. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart.